Did you know that the IRS settles out back taxes? The one most popular program is called the Offer and Compromise. My name is Sergio Melendez. I am an IRS tax expert. I have resolved millions of dollars on behalf of my clients in back taxes. Today, I will be discussing the different types of offer and compromise. So the IRS has this program called the Offer and Compromise, but there's three different types. There's one that's extremely popular and it's the one that gets more widely accepted by the IRS. I will tell you which one of the three it is. The very first option is known as effective tax administration. This is accepting the fact that you owe the money, there's no doubts of liability, and second of all, you have enough income and equity and assets to fully pay the balance. However, because of your circumstances, it would be completely unreasonable for the IRS to go ahead and try to collect the money from you. So that means it doesn't matter how much you owe. Right now we're looking at how reasonable it would be for you to pay the money back. So it doesn't matter if it's a $10,000 balance or a $10 million balance that you owe the IRS. Right now it's just saying that it's just unreasonable for the IRS to try to collect it. This is known as effective tax administration, or ETA. The second program is known as doubt as to liability program. This right here is when the IRS, there's a doubt that you owe the money. However, it is up to you to prove that you do not owe the tax balance. Doing this under circumstances is not based on your ability to pay or any type of equity and assets. This type of program is you have to have substantive proof that you just do not owe, and you file the offer and compromise as doubt as to liability with the IRS. And finally, the third program, and it is the most widely accepted program. Under these conditions, it is known as a doubt as to collectibility. Under these circumstances, there's no doubt that you owe the money. You owe the money for various reasons, but this part is you do not have enough income or assets to pay the IRS. That means that the IRS cannot squeeze this money out of you. So you go ahead and file an offer and compromise by offering the IRS a certain amount. They review the application, and if it makes sense, they accept your offer or might have a counter back. And this one is the one that's more widely used. This way you're not contesting the fact of owing the money, but it's just based on the fact that you just can't pay the money back. So those are the three basic types of offer and compromise. Sometimes you know which program you might fall into, whether it is ETA, doubt as to liability, or doubt as to collectibility. Are you thinking about filing an offer and compromise? If so, which one? Take a look at which three are best suited for you. Remember to hit like this video if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We're more than happy to provide more tax relief and tips coming your way. Thanks for watching.